All right, hello everybody, and welcome back to another Deepvue tutorial. This is going to be a really good one. We're going to be talking about how to find strong CANSLIM trading opportunities. We'll be building a screen from scratch here in Deepvue, which is the best platform for CANSLIM swing and position traders. And if you do find this video helpful, please go ahead and leave a like down below, subscribe if you're new to the channel. And if you aren't trying Deepvue just yet, highly recommend giving it a shot. We've got a special offer, 2 months for $39. Highly recommend picking it up. And that way you can follow along perfectly today as I share some really helpful tips and what I've kind of find helpful when I'm building a screen. So as I mentioned, we'll be talking about how to find and screen for strong CANSLIM stocks. I'll be talking about earnings growth, sales growth, liquidity, as well as relative strength. So first things first, in Deepvue, what you want to do first when you're building a screen is, of course, navigate to the screener module. Then we'll be going ahead and clicking this button to start a new screen. But first, let's take a step back and think about what we're looking for here. We're looking for stocks that are growing quickly, that you know are liquid enough that institutions will be able to position in them and are actually interested in them. And we, of course, want to make sure that there's some certain amount of momentum, liquidity, and trend associated with the stock. So those are kind of the criteria that we want to think about as we're thinking about which filter criteria and which data points we want to use for the screen. So let's go ahead and start and build the screen. So let's click this button here. This brings up our filter criteria. And what we're going to do first is look for earnings growth. So let's do EPS growth. Click any of these data points to quickly be brought to the data filter. And we're looking for the EPS growth, the latest quarter, and of course the minimum for CANSLIM is that 25%. So we'll go ahead and start with that. 100% if you want, 30% growth, 40% growth, you can tailor the screen to however you want. This is just an example to kind of run through the bare minimum of what you're looking for. And already you can see we basically dropped the number of stocks that we're looking at by a factor of 10 from about 11,000 to only about 2,000. So it's already a good start. And we want to narrow that focus as much as possible to really restrict and be very stringent about the stocks that we're willing to trade. So in addition to EPS growth of 25%, let's also add in sales growth of 25%. So very similarly, sales growth. And let's go ahead and also make the latest quarter greater than 25%. And in Deepvue, you've got these options, greater than, less than, or you can also say a range. So if you wanted 0 to 50% or negative 5% to 100%, you could use this range here and enter those values, click add, and that filter will automatically be applied to your screen. And in Deepvue, all the filters, all the applied filters and kind of the structure of the screen is shown right here. As you add them, and the symbols that pass through the screen are shown in real time over here. So let's go ahead and also restrict that to the latest quarter being greater than that 25% value. And look, we're now down to 500 results. That's definitely a good start. This is, certainly enough that you could actually go through each of these stocks on a weekend if you want a really wide view. But we also want to make sure that there's some sort of momentum as well as liquidity associated with these stocks. We don't want a stock, that's trading only 1,000 shares per day. And we also don't want a stock that, is in a downtrend and has no relative strength whatsoever. We want to be focusing on the stocks that are already, catching a bid and in a nice strong trend. So what we're going to do first is address the liquidity issue. And we've got the dollar volume data point here, which is super helpful. Dollar volume is basically the price multiplied by the average volume traded in a day. So the result is a dollar value, which is the dollars traded per day on average. So let's go ahead and make that greater than at least 20 million. That gives a nice kind of standard value, but I know traders who want a lot higher than this, 40 million, 50 million, even 100 million plus. It kind of depends on, the velocity of the stock that you want to trade, as well as, how liquid you really want that stock. If you really want to be focused on mega caps, you can make this value much, much higher. But let's go ahead and add that. And already we're at 50 results. So it's amazing how with just a few simple criteria, you can really restrict the universe you're in. And let's pause a little bit and look at the names that we've kind of brought up here. We've got Coinbase, CrowdStrike, Cyber, DDoG, Duolingo. We've got Google, Mara, Elf, MU, NVIDIA, Mara, NVIDIA, PDD, SMCI. So you're already seeing those CANSLIM type names just with these three criteria. So really this is all you need. You've got 50 results here. You can go through the charts individually, see if they appeal to you, see if they're setting up setups. But if you want to restrict it further, what we can do is add some relative strength requirements. So in Deepvue, to find those kind of performance type ratings, what you want to do is type in performance and click performance ratings. And we kind of have two main options here. We have the RS rating, which weights recent price action more. And then we've got the absolute strength rating, which is very similar to the RS rating, but there's no weighting applied to the recent price action. So it really depends on what you want. You know, both can be really helpful. I think RS rating is better if you're looking at a higher time frame, you know, a 12-month RS rating, that's really helpful. But if you're just looking for 3 month or 1 month absolute strength rating and looking to see what's performed best over the past month, the AS rating I think is pretty darn good. So we'll do AS rating 3 month, and let's say it has to be at least in the top 15 percentile. So we'll type in 85 here, add that, and there you go. From those 50 stocks, let's take a look at what we've got. We've got Coinbase, CLSK, Duolingo, NVIDIA, MU, so and TMDX, Wingstop. So it's very interesting to see kind of what themes we've got here. We've got software, we've got semiconductors, we've got crypto, and a little bit of hotels, restaurants, and leisures. And that's really what has been working recently. So it's amazing to see, you know, those names come up with, again, just four simple filters that we added in under 5 minutes. But if you do want to take it a step further and kind of open it up a little bit more, you can tweak this screen a little bit. And this is kind of what's unique to Deepvue. So say you don't need to see both earnings and sales growth. What you can do is create an OR condition to look for one or the other. And how you do that in Deepvue is basically click this button down here, add OR, and this is part of our advanced logic filter, and allows you to really get deep into your screening and really tweak it to however you would like it. So let's go ahead and click OR, and that creates another bucket here that we can add filters to. You select them by clicking them, and that way you can see which one you're adding those filters to. So we're gonna actually delete our earnings growth and sales growth from this bucket because we wanna put it back in here. And I'll walk through the entire screen after this to really, you know, take it step by step and talk about what we're doing. But let's go ahead and delete earnings growth, delete sales growth. You can see as the screen is becoming less restrictive, you're seeing more and more names come through here. And now, because we want to add those filters back to this bucket, we're going to click in here and again, type in EPS growth and latest quarter greater than that 25%. So now we've added back that filter, and let's do sales growth and add that filter back as well. There we go, there's the data point, 25. All right, and there we go. So now let's take a look at what we've done here. Our necessary requirements for a stock to pass through this filter is that it must have a dollar volume of over 20 million. It must have an absolute strength rating 3 month of greater than 85. So it must be outperforming, you know, 85% of stocks over that time frame, over the last 3 months. But then things get interesting once we get to this group too. So again, this is an OR group. So this is an AND group. Every single criteria must be met from this group, but it gets a little bit different once we get to this group. So here, once a stock passes through successfully these two filters, it approaches group two. And then only one of these criteria needs to be met for the stock to pass through the rest of the screen and show up on the results. So it could have earnings growth greater than 25%, or sales growth greater than 25%, or both of them, and it will show up on this list. But if it doesn't meet any of these criteria in group one, it won't show up at all. So you can add as many filters as you want to group two to make it actually less restrictive. So let's say if we go back to performance ratings, we want no matter what, if the stock is the strongest 5% of stocks in the last month, we want that to show up. So we'll go ahead and make sure we're clicked into group two and select 1 month and greater than 95 and add. So this makes the screen less restrictive because it's adding a possibility for the stock to make it through this entire screen. So now we need a requirement of a dollar volume, 3 month relative strength, but then we need earnings growth or sales growth or just really superior outperformance over the past month for a stock to make it all its way through this screen. So you'll see stocks in here that don't have earnings growth, that don't have sales growth. And what that means is that they've been really strong over the last month. So that's pretty much it for this video. Again, this results in 67 results. That's, you know, definitely restricted enough to quickly go through this screen, look for setups, look for spots where you can manage risk and potentially enter on breakouts or on pullbacks. But you know, it just kind of goes to show how powerful the Deepvue screener is, that you can just add, you know, four filters and quickly get to under 100 results of stocks. You know, a lot of people get paralyzed. You know, there's thousands and thousands of stocks in the market to trade. How do you find the best of the best, the top 1%? And this is how you do this. And what you want to do is every week, ideally every day, you go through this list, see what's shaping up, see what has strong earnings growth, the other parameters that you look for personally, whether that's a new product, a new service, you know, a great CEO, a great story. It's part of a larger theme, as you know, is currently the semiconductors, AI, crypto, software. Those are existing themes. And you take all that into account and go through these names and see kind of what's set up best for that week. And that's how you find ideas for CANSLIM trading. So that's pretty much it for this video. Let me know your thoughts down below. What filters would you add to the screen? What questions do you have about the entire process? We'd love to hear it. And if you have any suggestions for future tutorials, definitely let us know down below as well. But again, thanks so much for watching. Make sure you take advantage of that 2 months for $39 if you haven't yet. And I'll see you guys in future videos. Take care.